As a public institution, Western Nebraska Community College is committed to providing quality education, training opportunities, and support services through a variety of formats. WNCC seeks to meet the needs of the individuals and industries in our service area, allowing our graduates to enjoy a higher quality of life and enabling our industry partners the ability to grow and prosper. In response to such a need, the Powerline Maintenance and Construction Technology Program was born and is now fully operational. Ryan Reiber, General Manager of the Panhandle Rural Electric Membership Association, or PREMA, in Alliance, first came up with the idea of the program for Alliance.
Looking at this project of a power line school really came from the fact that we didn't have a power line school in 300 miles from this region. Another motivator was to just simply that we didn't have the linemen coming out of the schools wherever they were. And so we also knew that WNCC was interested and able to do this. They had capacity at the Alliance facility, which was excess capacity. And those were some of the primary reasons for beginning this process.
The same thoughts and challenges were facing another public utility in Sydney, Wheatbelt Public Power District. Avo Tyler, general manager, liked having the stability of homegrown employees and needed help to attract them.
We knew we had a problem at Wheatbelt when a lot of the young linemen coming from the schools in Mitchell and Northeast Community College, that as soon as a job came open back home, they'd leave. So we knew we had a problem. And I think Ryan was the one that kind of identified it as, you know, there isn't a school within 300 miles of here. And then from there we said, well, let's start one.
The task wasn't an easy one. Armed with the knowledge from an employer's perspective, Ryan and Avo organized field trips and fact-finding missions. The team visited the Powerline schools in South Dakota and Eastern Nebraska, defined challenges, and discovered opportunities.
We figured out what some of the pitfalls were, some of the challenges that we had to overcome. Then when Royce came along to the Alliance facility, and the folks from Sydney, Deanna Trowbridge and her folks, then things started to happen with WNCC. And from there, we started an advisory committee and really we started the wheels rolling on the whole project.
But they couldn't do it alone. The industry partners looked at developing training programs, and PREMA found that wasn't the best approach.
If we were to do this on our own, it would be expensive. We would be out doing something that we don't know anything about, and that's providing vocational training. So the partnership with WNCC is, it wouldn't happen if we didn't have that partnership.
WNCC also recognized the power of the partnership when the college was approached about the program. Dr. Royce Emmon, the director of the Alliance Center for WNCC, recognized the value of this partnership and knows the program wouldn't exist without the strong bond that's been created.
And it is such an interesting example of that because it brings together three pieces. It brings together higher education. It also brings together the industry. This idea was brought to us by industry. Industry has been instrumental, literally, in every single step that we took, every decision that we made, including bringing us the gold standard in curriculum and training for this.
The focus of the program has been to create a successful partnership because WNCC recognizes the critical nature of the program.
The Powerline program that WNCC has put together, we see as really being critical to the Panhandle. WNCC is very interested in being a good neighbor and a good citizen, and especially when it comes to rural America. We are a rural community college, and we see this program as instrumental in creating a better future for the people as well as the youth of the Panhandle of Nebraska. WNCC as an institution is all about partnering for the future. We realize that in rural America, if we're going to not only just barely survive, but thrive, organizations and institutions, businesses in rural America have to partner together if we're going to be competitive in the larger national and international economy. And so this program is really critical for WNCC because it represents in many ways a model for the future of what we believe higher education is going to look like in America.
It was then that the Powerline program began to grow. The past president of WNCC, Dr. John N. Harms, now a state legislator for Nebraska, wanted nothing but the best for the program.
When we started this program, we were committed to the fact that the very first day we offered the very first class to the very first students, that we wanted to look as if we had been doing this program forever.
From WNCC's perspective, the program had to be about two concepts, and only two concepts, safety and quality.
Dr. John Harms really is an individual to whom this program owes a tremendous debt for the quality emphasis and the safety emphasis that I think is going to be the primary legacy of this program for the future.
It's that emphasis on quality and safety that attracted students like Joel Duffield, a Chadron State College graduate and Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference track standout.
The quality of class, really. I mean, our professor John worked in the power line business. He knows all the strings to the business, and he can relate any aspect about the business to us, I mean, better than I've heard it explained before in my life.
John Corum, the Powerline instructor for WNCC, agrees that quality, along with safety, is important. It's what attracted him to the program, and his background makes him the perfect leader for the program.
My work experience, I worked for a public utility, a municipal utility, for almost 15 years in varying capacities, from apprentice lineman through journeyman lineman, worked some in training and safety there. During that time, I received a bachelor's degree and a master's degree from the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, in training and workforce development. So it is kind of a unique background for this kind of occupation.
However, he also says WNCC's commitment to student success is what makes the program one of the best in the nation.
For students, one thing is our student to faculty ratio. We try to keep that around 1 to 15 so that the students get the individual attention that they need. And another thing is just our commitment to student success. Students are welcome here. We try everything we can to make sure that their learning environment is very positive.
The need for the program is also not in question. With many Powerline workers classified as baby boomers, retirements will hit the electric distribution industry hard in the next 5 to 10 years.
A third of our operation folks in the rural electric field are going to be eligible for retirement in 10 years. And NRECA has some other figures that substantiate that. The baby boomer phenomenon is affecting us. We even have more of a problem because we have an average age that is higher than the average age of the country, of the workforce of the country. So that's going to be all good for these folks that are coming out of the school.
For some, that need is already here. That's why WNCC's program, based on the advisory committee's recommendations, has three different completion levels for students.
The associate's degree is probably the preferred completion level. Interestingly enough, that two-year degree can be accomplished in about 15 months very easily. Some of our students will accomplish it in 12 months. The power line portion of the training itself is 12 months in length. Depending upon the initiative of the individual student, they can actually complete the associate's degree in that 12 months, although it is an extremely intense 12 months. We also have a diploma level, and the diploma level would essentially get the student all the way through the power line training itself, but not the additional courses required to complete the associate's degree. The certificate level, which is essentially a 6-month level of training, includes the summer session and the fall session, does not include the spring session. The certificate level largely is designed as a completion level for those individuals who may already be working for, say, a municipality or a utility, but they want the individual to get some formal training to get some type of, if you will, a stamp of approval on their practical expertise that they've learned on the job through some type of an accredited, structured training program and a college curriculum.
The students aren't the only beneficiaries of the Powerline program. Utilities get to attract and keep qualified workers, and these workers can live and work in rural areas with high quality of life features. And many don't want to sit behind a desk all day. Joel Duffield didn't, so he sought a program in an industry in which he was familiar. With utility work in his family, he can appreciate what the profession can provide for a family.
Powerline sort of runs in the family for me. I have my father does powerline work, oldest brother in the powerline business, and I've been around it my whole life, I'm really familiar with it. And I worked there over one summer as a grunt, I guess I would say, and really enjoyed it, so decided to pursue that.
What type of students are the best fit for our program? The program seeks students that have one thing in common, a good attitude.
Good attitude is probably the primary ingredient, though. You have to have a good attitude coming into the school and a willingness to learn new things.
Joel agrees. As a student, he finds the same to be true.
Well, obviously, there's a physical attribute to it with all the climbing that we do, and but more or less, just attitude. You have to be hardworking because, I mean, you're going to face the elements of weather every day, and that's what makes the job fun. You're out in the sun one day, and then you're out at night in the rain the next day. People depend on you to put the power on, so it sort of gives you a sense of pride, too.
By now, you realize how important the Powerline program is to the college, the municipalities, and the industry as a whole. In order to take the program to the next level, we need your help. But how can you help?
Donating time, money, support, speaking to their colleagues about the program, sending their graduates, their high school graduates or others, providing scholarships.
WNCC is formulating plans to expand the program and is grateful for the support already received. This support has come in many forms: money, donated equipment and supplies, time and effort on advisory boards, and scholarships. Some of the more recent donations include a truck from Wheat Belt and a truck from the city of Gehring. We're ready to grow the program, and we invite you to join us. To see what would work best for you, contact one of our representatives today. Or get more information from our website at powerline.wn.edu.
Go to WNCC!